little side action, and we're just about set to kick off. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Iowa State is ready to open this one up as they line up for the opening kick. He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20. And he's taken down at the 28-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. Caught over the middle, and he's taken down at about the 39-yard line. So they complete that for about 7 yards, and they'll pick up a first down.
He has such a quick first step. Once he made that initial move to the inside on the slant, he already had the space he needed for the first down.
He makes his way to about the 42. They go with the option and pick up the first down.
Yeah, and that was a situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
Brought down at the 43-yard line.
Boy, did you see how the defense just swarmed to the ball carrier? That was fantastic pursuit.
From the 43-yard line, it's second down. Taken down at the 31-yard line.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
He's on the run. Tackle right around the 24-yard line. That makes it second and two. Tackle made just outside the goal line.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
He's scrambling. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown. Decided to improvise and took it in for the touchdown.
And this is why this guy is such a special player. This is what makes the offense even more difficult to stop. When a quarterback can take it himself and run, that's just one more weapon the defense has to account for.
He makes the PAT. So that's an 8-play, 73-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
And it was really those long runs that really helped propel that drive.
So our score, 7-0. And he'll return this one from the 7. He's out to the 30. And he just got drilled. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. And he tackles him hard at the 47. Makes it out to about the 36. Looks for his tight end over the middle. And he's tackled at about the 23-yard line.
How about the big fellas up front? This line will have to continue to play like that to build the consistency to help this offense be effective.
Complete, and he's got space to work, and he's level at the 14-yard line.
You know what? After a play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
Oh, He's got an opening. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score. Pitches back. Touchdown, Cyclones. Score by the halfback.
And a nice call by the coach there. Just give it to your main man anytime you're near the goal line.
They'll line up for the extra point in an attempt to tie the game. And he hits the PAT. A six-play, 66-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. We get a tie game at 7-7. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And offense is back on the field after running the ball very well on their last drive.
This offensive line really opened up some big gaps for the running back last time.
Makes it to the 34. Side. He makes it to the 35-yard line. Tackled after a decent pickup. Off left, and they got it behind the line. Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on the 37-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. And down he goes at the 45-yard line. Quick throw to the tight end. He's tackled right around the 48-yard line. Toss. And he carries the ball for a nice game.
That's a game of 7 on the play. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
Nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
Now he's scrambling, and he's sacked.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
So that sack sets them back a little bit now. They're looking at 2nd and 13. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. Now he tries to buy some time. He takes off. They'll bring him down at the 18-yard line. In the shotgun and 5 wide outs. In the open, and they make the stop at the 11-yard line.
Makes the reception. Number 7 on the tackle at the 11-yard line.
They come out in a 5 wide set. Fires it out, and that's sets them up with a first and goal.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
They're giving away free yards and only making life easier for the guys on the other side of the ball.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. And here's the 14th play of the drive.
Yep, he punched that in from a short distance. He had great blocking up front on that play.
And he converts the extra point. Illinois is lining up to kick this one off. He's to the 20. Makes it to the 22-yard line. And while they are behind, they know they can knot things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. On the ground, inside. Makes it out to about the 33. Talk about scoring. A huge first quarter by both teams. 14-7, Illinois. We're back for more action here in quarter number two. Nice run up the middle. Gets out to about the 44-yard line. That's a great tackle at the 33. Makes his way out to about the 25. Might have been some early movement up front.
False start, offense.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
Second and eight coming up here. Ball on the 30-yard line. Completely stopped immediately. How about that play?
That's a good pickup there. He just dropped back and delivered a nice throw.
He has some room. Gains his way to the 13-yard line. Got a player down, obviously in some pain. Here's the eighth play of the series. Makes it to the 5. Be tied with the extra point. And he adds kicks the extra point. Iowa State is ready to kick it away. Caught at the 8. He gets out to about the 32-yard line.
Both these defensive coordinators have got to be going crazy right now. We've had 4 straight possessions in which these offenses have put points on the board.
They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Receiver's got the first down, and he's taken down at midfield. They'll work the left side with a counter play. He makes his way out to about the 35. Off play action. Now he's on the move. Fakes to the back. Runs with it, and he's got room. Brought down at about the 13. Gets to about the 11-yard line.
That makes it 7.
Third down, 7 yards to go. Ball on the 11. The Cyclones saw one of their top players going down earlier. It looks like he's going to be able to get back in there. Throws out to the running back, no good.
You know, sometimes the toughest throws to make for a quarterback is when he has a wide receiver wide open. And everybody in the stands is saying, throw it, throw it. And you aim the football instead of just getting back in rhythm, stepping, and throwing. And that time, you aim the ball, and it was incomplete.
And it's good.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
Illinois kicked this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Makes it out to about the 40. But he can't shake the defense.
I think he could have taken a risk down the field, but he played it safe instead, and that's one of the keys to winning ball games.
The sub package in there defensively in this 5 wide receiver set. Very good tackle in space. The quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Once and all, going deep. The defender had it and then dropped it.
Boy, a golden opportunity missed by the defense. That was a sure interception only to be dropped.
Second and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. Screen pass. He's got his halfback. And no one can get it. It bounces out of bounds. Him hard at the 22-yard line.
second and four.
And that one's incomplete. He's unable to hit his receiver. He overthrew it.
Yeah, and that's a throw he should make every single time.
They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Quick pass. He goes out of bounds at the four. First down, and they come to the line with a first and goal. Defense stacked in tight here. He's taken down at the 1 yard line. A couple, maybe 3 yards on that run. 10th play of the drive. Iowa State's going to have to use their second time out of the half. Touchdown, Cyclones. Tacks on the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Taken from the 10. Gets out to about the 31. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Defense goes with the extra defensive backs as the offense comes up five wide. Quick throw out to the receiver. Tackle made at the 34-yard line. Second down and 7. Ball on their own 34. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Tackle at the 49. Illinois will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. And he throws it away. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
From their own 49-yard line. It's second down. He airs it out. And he's hit immediately. Got him. And he goes down quickly. Scrambling around. Room around the corner. He decides to run with it. Touchdown, Fighting Illini. Trying to go up by 3. They'll kick the extra point. He makes the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Both teams have had a lot of success on the offense here today.
It's been fun to watch these two quarterbacks play. Right now, they are both just executing in a way that you always hear that term, they're in the zone. Both these quarterbacks, and both these offenses, for that matter, are definitely in the zone.
And he's level at the 36-yard line. Quick throw, and he's got his man again. And he's tackled at the 47-yard line. Going deep. We've seen quite a bit of offense here as we reach halftime. Illinois has got a three-point lead.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Both of these offenses came in looking for balance. I don't know how much balance you need when you're averaging 6 yards a carry. Just keep running that thing. And I know it never happened to you, but what do you think it would be like for defensive linemen who are getting run on like this?
Well, I guess their balance needs to be checked. They're just going backwards. They need to get their equilibrium figured out and start going forward a little bit and balancing out the line of scrimmage. But, you know, it's demoralizing. When a team can line up and say, we're going to run the football, we're going to run it right here, and you can't do anything about it, there's nothing that gets in your head anymore. I mean, you get frustrated. Then you don't get to do what you love to do as a defensive lineman, rush the passer. It's all about the ground game. It's all about if you're going to bring your big boy pads in the second half. Are you going to man up, move the line of scrimmage on the other side of the football, and make some plays? Because right now, you just look like a little boy at the table.
David's ready to get back on that couch, get the remote, get all the games dialed up to watch what's going on around the country. Time to get you back for your second half. Brad and Kirk, ready to roll.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half.
Number 18,
from the 8-yard line, he's out to the 30. Tackle at the 47.
Well, this is a competitive game. It's fun to watch these two teams go back and forth. Just when you think one team has the edge, the other gets right back into it. It's exciting.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. And down he goes at the 50. He makes it to the 48-yard line. Screen. They'll bring him down at the 46-yard line. The man defense proves to be too tough against the screen.
That was an excellent job by the defenders. They fought off their blocks and found the ball before the play had a chance to develop.
He's going to aim this one to the sideline, try to kick it out of bounds. And this one is a beauty. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Illinois is up by 3. On play action, he'll scramble. He's tackled around the 29-yard line. And they make the stop at the 30. Play action here. He's going to scramble. Looks like he's going to run. He scrambles. Decides to slide.
That's good for 4 yards. That makes it 2nd and 6.
And off to the left. They'll knock him down for a loss.
Think about the speed and instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
Third down now, and they need to get it out to the 50. And he's going to come up with a sack.
Losses 8 yards on the play.
and he just got drilled. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. And he tackles him hard at the 48. They go with a run, and that'll be a gain of 9. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. It to the 41.
That makes it 7-2.
Gets out to around the 28. Pretty much stuffed on that run.
You know what, that was just a nice job by the defense in stopping him before he could get going and build up momentum.
From the 32-yard line, second down. Up the middle for a nice game. Fires out quickly to the tailback, and they hit him in the backfield. So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board. Iowa State is down 3 and looking to tie it up. He gets it up, and he splits the uprights. Like they're ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Time's getting a little bit tighter now. You got to make every possession count. Here's the halfback on the screen, and they get him in the backfield for a loss. From their own 23-yard line, second down. Zips it to the tight end. And he's taken down at the 34. He steps out around the 34-yard line. Tackled at the 36. A lot of times you'll see teams start to clinch up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. Just throws this one away. So at the end of the third quarter, we get a tie game here, knotted at 24. Who's going to win the fourth quarter? Whoever does will win the ball game. Steps out of bounds at about the 39-yard line.
That makes it 37.
Fires out to his receiver. You've got to wonder here early in the fourth quarter if that stop and a play like that might be the momentum swing this team needs to win it. He drops it. You know, it's basically like we're starting from zero here in a one-quarter game now. Every possession is vital. Tackled after a decent pickup. Around 4 yards there on the quarterback keeper. The extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Gathered in at the 6. He's taken down at the 27. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. He's going to try and scramble. Brought down at the 41-yard line. Quickly, and he's got his man. He's taken down at about the 47-yard line. Tackle made around the 36-yard line. He makes his way to about the 28.
That's a gain of 8 on the play. That makes it 2nd and 2.
Tackle after a decent run up the gut.
That's good for a gain of 7 yards. First down.
Gets rid of it.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
2nd and 10. All on the 21. Well, as they take a look at that injury on the sideline, let's see what this backup can do at quarterback. Fires out to his wideout. It out to maybe the 13-yard line. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Just under 3 to go in regulation. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Bring him down in the backfield. Here's the 11th play of the drive. gets to about the 8-yard line. The halfback picks up a yard.
Yeah, it was a short gain, but a nice tackle there by the junior who stepped up in traffic and made a nice play.
Quick shot to the tailback and through his hands. So it's fourth down. They're going to go for the easy three here. Kicks up, and he got it. Illinois to kick this one off. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Halfback's got it on a quick throw. Tackle at about the 29-yard line. Second and six. Ball on the 29. The screen is good for four. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Makes it to the 37.
Now, the defense knew that this offense was trying to work the clock. When you want to work the clock, you're going to run the football. It puts a lot of pressure on the offensive line to get low and drive that defensive line back. And that's what they were able to do there to give the running back enough room to pick up that first down.
Illinois out of timeouts. He gets hit out of bounds around the 38-yard line. From the 38-yard line, it's first down. He gets out to about the 35-yard line. And he's tackled around the 25-yard line. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. Nothing more demoralizing for a defense than seeing the opposing quarterback take a knee. And this is the 8th play of the drive. And this one comes to an end. Our final count in this game, 31-27, Iowa State. That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.